This is Fred with Wentworth CCTV of New England, and today we will be covering the much anticipated video 6 of our security camera installation series, and that will be installing the HIK Connect phone app for remote viewing your cameras, which is a fairly simple process. You'll have to go to your app store. I'm in the Play Store, the Google Play Store, because I have an Android phone. You'll also have an app store with the Windows phone. We're just going to type HIK Connect, and it's going to bring up the IBMS 4500 program you see up on top. We want to install that. Okay, as you can see, this has downloaded, so we will open the app. It's going to ask you if you want to manage phone calls, and I always put an eye to that because I don't use my NVR to make phone calls. Don't know why that's there. But we do want it to be able to access our photos because we are going to take still shots and video clips with this program, and it needs access to that part of our phone. So we'll hit allow there. And it will ask us our region, which is the Americas and the great US of A. Enter. And now we're in the app. So we need to go to the top left corner. There's a menu button, and where it says not logged in, we want to hit that. And this will allow us to register our account with the cloud, with HIK Connect. So we're going to click register HIK Connect here. We're going to enter our email. It asks for phone number or email. In my experience over the years, email works much better. Some phone numbers you have to add a 1 before, some you don't. Some telephone providers, like T-Mobile, for whatever reason, don't work that great with the verification process. So it's always easiest just to put your email in, and that always works fine. So whatever your email is, go ahead and enter that. I will enter mine as well. New England CCTV at Gmail. We're going to have to accept the terms and agreements, and we're going to get a verification code. So HIK Connect now is going to send you a email with your verification code. Mine is 5101. Okay. Now we're going to create a username and password that is specific to your account. So, okay, so we are going to enter username and password. Hit finish. And sure enough, we are into HIK. So we can add our device. It's going to ask us if we want to allow IBMS to take pictures and video. We can do that while using the app. And we are going to hit the manual add button in the top right corner of the screen. It looks like a piece of paper and a pen. And it's going to ask for a 9-bit serial number. This is the serial number of your recorder. And we will find that two ways, either by using the SADP tool, the discovery tool that we discussed in video 3, or you can manually log into your recorder using the internet by typing the IP address of the recorder in the browser, pulling it up and going in the settings. So we will cover that briefly. Okay, we have logged into our recorder. You can see it's a Hikvision recorder. This one is a DS7216 HGHI DVR, but the NVR settings are pretty much the same. Once you log into your recorder, you're going to go to the configuration tab, and you're going to click device information, which will be located under device parameters. This will list all the information for your recorder, including the firmware, so on and so forth.
but the serial number is what we're paying attention to, because the HIK Connect phone app connects to your recorder by its serial number through the cloud. The serial number, as you remember, is a 9-digit or 9-bit number. And it's always the last number sequence in the serial number. So the serial number is the model number, and it will have a series of numbers, some letters. It's the last 9 numbers. So we just cut and paste that.
All right, so in the HIK Connect app, we left off where it was asking for the 9-bit or 9-digit serial number. And that is the number that we cut and pasted from the recorder in the device information tab. So we will go ahead and enter that. And hit search. And that is going to find your device on the cloud. You can hit the plus right here, and it's going to ask you for the verification code that you set up in the recorder when you enabled the HIK Connect process. So we are going to now go back into the recorder settings and set up this verification code.
Okay. So let's pull up the recorder. Through the internet. And once we log in, we will go to the configuration tab right here. And in the configuration tab, under networking, we're going to do a couple things. We're going to make sure under the general networking that the recorder is set up in DHCP, which ensures it works smoothly with the modem or router it's networked with. We're also going to go into platform access. We're going to make sure HIK Connect is enabled. And we're going to create that verification code. So the verification code is something you make. It has to be 6 to 12 letters, and it is case sensitive. So you want to make sure you remember what it is. Okay, so we're enabled. We have our verification code, and we're going to save.
All right, so we will enter the serial number. Search the cloud for our recorder. There it is. We'll hit the plus sign to add it. And there is the verification code that we just set up. So we'll confirm that. And lo and behold, we've added our recorder to the HIK Connect account. To view your cameras, you can click on the camera. And there we have our camera has populated. You can double click, or double tap, I should say, the picture in the top left corner. When you double tap it, it will bring it up live view onto the screen. This camera shot is of a self-storage facility. But that is hooking your NVR up to HIK Connect. And viewing your cameras remotely. As always, please like our video, subscribe for our premium content. We will have some newer videos coming out on operating IVMS on your phone, the HIK Connect app, doing playback, taking snapshots and video clips, emailing those and stuff like that. So the resources you've been given so far are setting things up, and now we're going to get into using them.